Hello!
Welcome. How are we doing?
We've got a brewery here that we haven't had for a while now.
A lot of their beers quite really good.
They're very rare around here in Yorkshire. But the ones we've had, I think, have been nice. There's a bit of an air, which is similar to the Watership Down.
Did I get this from Cambridge? I can't remember.
I think it might be.
Because
we bought so many beers over that time period.
But
to see us through to end of the year, didn't we?
Yeah. Well, the beer is.
See it? Yeah, smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Got, both got black t shirts on, so.
Noticeable.
There's a little bit of. See, it's a smooth stout. Right.
A bit prune, is it?
But yeah, I mean, one of our childhood cartoons, Watership Down, that had like hares on it and rabbits and stuff like that. There's the head. It's slight cocoa head. It's not totally cocoa, it's almost like off white.
Yeah.
Face. Slight nuttiness. Colour is dark.
Yeah, that's like carbonation on the side there.
So carbonation?
See there, look. See the bubbles outside.
Does it smell? It's disappearing, that's all.
It does have a nice cocoa velvet.
So it's almost got like a dirtiness to it, smell. Definitely rich chocolate.
Very smooth.
You smell? Well, it does say smooth on the. It says smoothed out. You're not getting too much chocolate.
No, it's just.
It's almost like. Again, we're having a few stouts.
But it says here, we build the dark side using a blend of dark roasted malts and old fashioned. And rather famous English hop called the Fuggles.
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 Fuggles hops. Which I think is an English hop.
So I don't know. Is it an old way of doing it, or for them, or? It's a roasted barley aroma, deep dark colour and smooth yet dry taste. All the hallmarks of it.
Yeah, it's now getting more of a dark coffee, dark chocolate.
Yeah. I'll take a good sniff there.
What's the ABV on it?
Well, it's 4%,
so it's not bad. Because normally, low ABV beers.
Yeah.
You're not supposed to get much from them anyway, are you, really?
No, I mean, I don't know. I've had some that have had pretty good, but. But for a stout, it's a bit.
Let's take a chug. Definitely more like blackberries.
Yeah.
And the roast malt. There's not
almost
much.
Almost slight tone of prunes or something. Almost.
It's not bad. Could you session it easy?
Yeah.
You'd be drinking it like it's water.
Yeah.
Is it watery on the flavour? No, the flavour's continuous. There's no water dissipation.
I sort of just noticed now. It's sort of like the dryness after.
I think it's one of those where after a few, you would get more flavour out of it.
Yeah.
It's at room temperature, so that's perfect for stouts, I think. We found out.
Yeah, because. I think the ball on
there's a slight nuttiness and a slight bit of I'm getting the prune now. And some slight bit of
impressive pour.
Not too much, because.
Is it the bear?
Yeah, I think it's got more like. Dark currants and raisins and all those mixed fruits.
Yeah. I mean, like I say, probably.
But it's going down really easily, going really nice. Would you buy it again? I would.
Yeah, I mean,
if the price is right, if it's.
I mean, like we all beers, though, it's worth trying on cask.
Yeah.
So if we're ever in Bath, probably got to try it on cask.
Where is it from? It's
well, Bath.
Bath Hills at Warmley.
Oh, Warmley. I assumed it was at Bath. You know, so I think it was not far from there.
But 4%, and it's the easiest sessionable beer.
Mm.
It goes down well. There's no... Not a bad thing to say about it. It's just lovely. Like, it does remind me of the Ilkley Black.
Yeah.
Which is a low ABV dark beer as well.
Well, that's it, yeah.
And that's a lovely beer as well.
It's a session.
Yeah. Definitely worth buying. If it's 250 like a normal ale, probably...
What, on bottle or
Yeah, pint. Bottle.
Or pint.
Well, if you buy a bottle and it's £2.50, is it worth it? It's a push, unless it's on a, like a multi-deal.
Yeah.
If it's on offer at £1.50, which is, I think, the Sainsbury's deal, it's about that price. I won't price it any more than £1.50, probably about £1.80. If it were in a pub, I'd buy a pint.
Well, £2.15 or
£2.50? It's normally £3 for a pint of ale.
Yeah.
It's worth it on cask. But anyway, you take care.
Bye.